Good morning. Thank you very much to UN Women and thank you very much to the Agribusiness team for inviting me today to this event. It's actually after 1.5 years pandemic, it's a great pleasure to be physically in a conference. In a way, it feels strange because we were used to last 1.5 years actually to stay at home and to work on, continue our job actually on the digital format. We learned a lot, I think. Now coming back to the question was asked, I mean, before we maybe move to the question and challenges what women in the agricultural fields have, it's important to look to setting the scene on the women in agriculture. I mean, Alia already mentioned, women are in agriculture make up to 40% of the labor force worldwide. In some continents, like in Africa, it's more than 50%. But women participate across various activities in value chain with lower economic returns than men. So when you look to the statistics, just recently, actually, there was a World Bank research work, which was reporting that the gender gaps mentioned as gross value of crop output produced per hectare, in country like in Nigeria, it's 30%. So it's lower. So there is a lot of work to do, and when it's really important to understand why women are less included in the value chain. And when we look to the value chain, actually, the chain starting with inputs, production, cooperation, I mean, that's cooperatives are a very important pillar of it, and also the processing and the transport, marketing, sales, I mean, all these five pillars, women are have their challenges. When we look to inputs, women often lack knowledge about the access to high quality inputs. I mean, some previous speakers have already mentioned this. When it comes to production, it's also important actually that women less often don't have the ownership of land titles. My previous speaker mentioned this. I don't want to go too much on the challenges on the value chains. I think all previous speakers actually mentioned this. My position at Frankfurt School, also at the EBTN, actually is actually the responsibility to looking on a sustainable finance matter. I mean, when we talk about the sustainable finance, we look actually on the one side, sustainable finance means actually solid financial system in an economy. On the other side, also financially literate consumers, farmers, and producers in a sector. From the banking side or financial sector system, side, the biggest challenge for women is actually the limited income to access to finance. Goldman Sachs was some years ago, actually, I think almost 6-7 years ago, have reported global credit gap on women businesses is 800 billion, and there is a actually untouched potential for many financial institutions to tap in this market. I have worked the last 10 years with my team. I have a team of 150 colleagues working in Frankfurt, but also in countries like in Turkey, in Kazakhstan, in Tajikistan, but also in the African region, in the Nairobi office. We are working in advising banks to identify actually or to target women businesses, women farmers as clients. There is a potential for many banks actually to enter new markets, but they are scared about women because, as we have already, we know from our speakers, due to the fact that the women have low access to ownership of land, but they have also limited access actually to training and also through the cultural situations in many countries, they don't have access to networking, to be also engaged in participation in cooperatives, also on leaderships. So the for banking actually is more difficult for them. We are advising, or we have advised more than 30 banks the last years, and the main work we have actually done is really looking to the bank's portfolio, assessing their portfolio from a baseline side, and identifying actually the current portfolio of the banks, and identifying also actually from a market research perspective the demand of banks and the women, and helping the banks in development of products and also marketing these products. We could see actually in many cases of this cases we had in our portfolio, there was a huge increase of bank's portfolio on women enterprises, women farm, women portfolios after we have started the advisory work. So the specific barrier actually really is on this, on the one side, limited income, access to finance, but also limited access to education and training. And we learned, or we worked with our partner institutions together and helped them also not only on the bank product side, development of the bank and bank, we have also helped them to make the loan officers to understand the language of the woman, but also the woman in agriculture, and to align their products, their services in alignment with the needs of them. When we talk, really summarize this, barriers preventing woman-owned businesses in agriculture, we can actually summarize this in a way to say women have really difficulties to access to market, and they have also reduced access to customers, but also the domestic duties are challenging them, and access to communication and technologies are hindering them also to ability to operate remotely and to reach customers. And during the COVID crisis now, we could see this challenge become a bigger challenge actually. So, accompanied with the limited access to finance, actually the COVID-19 crisis had reiterated the need to address socioeconomic inequalities and to need to provide greater access to productive resources, technology, and innovation to empower women towards more sustainable food system. What we could see is also that during the situation, COVID crisis, women were more hit from the pandemic situation. They had to have the homeschooling and also the sickness in the family was actually more under the burden of the woman in the family. So on the other side, we could see also during the COVID crisis, many opportunities arise from this pandemic situation. From one day to the second day, the woman had actually to invest, to shift to digital, and we have really nice cases where this digitalization and the access of digital marketing, digital education, offered also new opportunities for these women. Because even though in the past they could not attend trainings because the trainings were happening also in big cities, so they had to travel there, but with the introduction of this Zoom and MS Teams kind of trainings, you know, there was a mind shift. So the private sector, but also on the SMEs, the training institutes, the banks, the financial institutes, they started really to communicate with their clients. When we talk about targeted programs, I think we will talk about it later on. I think really it's really important also to invest more in this digitalization of education and also hybrid and blended education, and to make the crisis also to an opportunity and to you know, the next level, I think, in the development finance sector will also be more innovative in terms of that the advisory is not in a classical time, you know, it started 20 years ago in the sector. We were having a mandate, and we were traveling to the country, and we were spending 1, 2, 3 weeks or 3 years in the country. Now we can really make smaller pieces of capacity building, and we can really provide this on a long-term, more sustainable manner to the target group. So that's my presentation. Thank you very much.